Welcome to the Writer's Block. I'm Barry Trammell in Oklahoma City at the Oklahoman, down in Austin with the American Statesman, my old pal Cedric Golden, and we're here to talk about the weekend sports. And Cedric, the big news was the retirement of an NFL icon. Rob Gronkowski hangs it up with the New England Patriots, goes out as a Super Bowl champion. Cedric, is Rob Gronkowski the best tight end we've ever seen in the NFL?
No, he's not, but he's close. I have to give the edge to Tony Gonzalez, Barry. I know Tony Gonzalez didn't experience the postseason success that Gronk experienced, but Tony Gonzalez also didn't have Tom Brady throwing him the football. So I think if you look at the numbers, Gronk, 79 TD catches, 79 TD catches, is a lot, but I'm going to go Gronkowski second to Tony Gonzalez, and then you bring in Shannon Sharp, Ozzie Newsome, and for Cowboy fans, you want to throw Jason Witten in there. I'm fine with that, but there have been some great tight ends. I'm going to give Tony Gonzalez, who had the longevity that Gronk did not have. Tony Gonzalez missed 28. Tony Gonzalez only missed like four games in his career. Gronk missed like four games a season. So give him his props. He was great, great run blocker. But I think that Tony Gonzalez gets the edge.
Well, how unique is Gronkowski considering the cocoon in which he played? He's there at New England where everybody is a Stepford wife. They follow the Patriot way. Nobody steps outside the box. And here comes this loose cannon, this fun-loving personality, this guy who is able to sort of supersede the Bill Belichick, Tom Brady box of deportment, and not necessarily a cartoon character, but a lovable character who does wild things and yet is able to flourish in that New England system.
You know, he was a fun-loving guy, but he wasn't a fun-loving guy that was going to end up on the police blotter. He wasn't straight cash homie like Randy Moss. He was chugging beers and taking his shirt off in Vegas casinos and stuff like that in the off season. He was never a distraction to his team. When it came time to work, Gronk was ready to go. He worked hard and he played hard off the field. Nothing wrong with that. So I don't really think that he superseded that box. When the season started, he was coloring inside the lines as the New England way was. So I just don't see him as one of those guys who was kind of a rebel. Gronk was a partier, but he wasn't a rebel. And I'm going to say this. We keep talking about him in the past tense, Bear. Rob Gronkowski will play football again. Let's not get it twisted.
That was where I was going to go next. You mentioned Jason Witten. A year ago, Witten retires, goes into the Monday Night Football broadcast booth, has come out to return to the Cowboys. What's your vision for Gronk's future? Any chance he tries the broadcast booth? And what are the odds that he is back, as you said, playing football again?
God, I hope not. He will be horrible in the booth. He doesn't come across as the most effusive guy out there, the most articulate. I mean, I'm not hating on it, but please spare us Gronk in the booth. Outside of becoming a professional wrestler, which is a very real possibility, it's totally within his personality, and he's appeared in some WWE events. It's totally within his personality to do something like that. If that doesn't happen, I could see him either coming back to play next year, having a change of heart, as his agent Drew Rosenhaus told the media, or taking a year off and then coming back. Rob Gronkowski's 29 years old, Bear. He's coming back. He's not going to just be sitting around in his 30s doing nothing. He's going to play football again, or he's going to be a professional wrestler. We're going to see him on TV sometime soon.